listening to the Spectacular Magazine Radio Show on Foxy 107-104.
Spectacular Magazine Radio Show, your community-focused resource. I'm your host, Phyllis Coley. Today, we're talking about empowering our youth. Black Space is a digital maker space based out of Durham and Chapel Hill, North Carolina. They offer black and brown youth a breathing space to manifest their dreams by any medium necessary. Yep. Joining me now is the founder of Black Space, Pierce Freelon. Welcome to Spectacular Magazine Radio Show.
Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure to be here.
Now, this information came from your website. Mm-hmm. So let's really explain to our listeners what Black Space really is.
Black Space is a studio where kids can come and learn about music production, coding, videography. It is a free program. We try to teach them not only the technical and entrepreneurial skills, but also about kind of community building and solidarity. And it's just a beautiful creative space for young artists.
So when did you start it? When did you found that?
I founded Black Space, our Chapel Hill studio, in 2014. Mm-hmm. It was previously a creative space called Beatmaking Lab that was specifically music-centered. It kind of grew out of a course I was teaching in the music department across the street at UNC Chapel Hill. Mm-hmm. And then after Michael Brown was killed that August, we took a radical shift in our kind of programming and identity to make it more something that was kind of centered around black youth and black culture specifically.
So these are just, are people who just are looking to rap? Or no?
Well, I mean, so here's the thing. A lot of kids come into Black Space like, oh, I want to record on my mixtape. Like, can I come through and do that? And we tell them, look, I'm glad you can rap and you got bars and you want to make a mixtape, but before we get into that, we need to teach you about recording vocals, about mixing and mastering, about music production. We're not yanking beats off YouTube for you to rap over somebody else's beats. You need to make your own beats. And so with that in mind, it is a space that really centers social entrepreneurship. We want kids to walk away not just as creators, but as businessmen and businesswomen and business folk that are able to do more than just rap.
When you say more than rap, but they do get an opportunity to perform. That was one of the things that I was just very impressed with. Let's talk about your Every Friday.
Oh yeah, the Cypher. Yeah.
Yes.
So downtown Durham, every single Friday at 9:19, we gather all of our youth and we do what's called a Cypher. Now a Cypher is a circle of MCs, poets, music producers, DJs, mostly in high school. And we create together, and it's a really beautiful space and an opportunity for the kids to share some of what they've been working on. It is a space where we prioritize and emphasize improvisation. Okay. So in a jazz context, you call that a solo. In rap, we call that freestyling.
Okay.
So the kids are rapping off the top of their head. It's a collaborative space. We do it at 9:19 because we in the 919.
Okay.
Right? Representing Raleigh and Durham's area code and Chapel Hill. And it's just a weekly ritual that gives kids an opportunity to express themselves and share their art with the people of Durham.
But don't you find that to be empowering?
Of course, of course. Listen, kids out there are creating something. And here's the thing about, a freestyle. You've created some lyrics, some poetry on the spot. Mm-hmm. And then you're encircled by an audience that is reacting to your lyrics. So you've now created something and shared it and gotten immediate critical feedback, and that is an incredibly, it helps with self-esteem. We've got kids starting businesses coming out of the Cypher, writing poems that they've gone on to perform on stages throughout the city. Kids have been DJing, now they can take those DJing skills to go DJ parties. Kids are making beats, we've been licensing beats with local television and radio stations. Mm-hmm. And these kids are learning these skills in this very nurturing environment with black adult professionals showing them the ropes. And it's incredibly, not just empowering, but just inspiring.
Yes. How would a kid get into that program? Or as a parent, how could I get my child in that program?
You just go to Black Spaces website is theblackspace.org. Mm-hmm. And there you can find our contact information. You can follow us on social media. You can show up to an event. We do ciphers every Friday. We've been in what's called a chrysalis period all summer. We've been kind of rebuilding the organization, and we probably won't launch programs again until the spring of 2020. But, you know, we'll be ready for them when they're ready to come back.
But you also teach coding, don't you?
Yeah, we do coding programs. We do a wide variety of programming across mediums. We call it up. We say by any medium necessary. So that's photography, videography, coding, music production, all of the above.
Even puppetry.
Puppetry as well. And we've also been getting kids into politics. We've been trying to make sure that our youth are politically engaged, that they're aware of the issues in their community, and that they're kind of stepping in. I mean, these kids, most of our kids are 16, 17, so they're not old enough to vote yet, but we want to make sure that by the time they hit 18, they're ready to engage in civic life.
Give that website again, please.
Our website is theblackspace.org.
And so you said so now is a really good time for people to go online and register as you're looking to start back in the fall.
Yeah, actually we're looking at probably next spring. We think about as semesters, you know, it'll be like the January semester before we launch programs again.
And do you have to be from Durham?
You don't have to be from Durham. You could be from anywhere. You could be from Alabama, Nebraska, okay. Arkansas, wherever. But, you know, our studios, we have a studio in Durham and one in Chapel Hill, so that would be a great place to be close to if you want to get involved in the program.
And it's a safe space, isn't it?
Oh, my goodness. We don't use the word safe space because we think it's a little cliche. We use the word breathing space. Mm. Black space is a space where black youth come and they feel like they can breathe easy.
And they can be themselves. Pierce, thank you. And thank you so much for what you do for the community. I would personally, you know, I told you and I talked about this.
Yeah.
I would like to see this go into some of the rural counties,
yeah,
if at all possible. But you're willing to train people if there are people in those counties that they can do the same thing in their county.
Well, yeah, here's the thing. I'm running for a state senate right now. One of the things I hope to do when I'm in Raleigh is create funding opportunities for arts programmings throughout the state. So I'm running for state senate in District 20, but as a state senator, I'll represent the entire state of North Carolina. And there are a lot of resources, a lot of artists. There's North Carolina Central University is in Durham. Like, there's a lot of resources in the urban centers, but we definitely need more arts programming, especially for black and brown youth in the rural corners of the state.
So in about 6 months or 8 months, I'd like to come back and maybe talk about that, and I hope that that will be something that has expanded.
Cool.
And
yeah,
has expanded. That would be wonderful.
I would love to come back. Thank you.
And thank you so much for being here today and for what you do for our community. That's going to do it for me this Sunday morning. I want to thank my guest, Sergeant Renee Lockhart and Pierce Freelon. Thank my in-studio team, Lawrence Davis, D.C. Collins, and Brian Hayes.
And can I say happy birthday to you,
thank
too?
You, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It was great, but I'm still celebrating.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. And until next time, see ya.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Did it.
Woo!